welcome back.
I hope, children, you are all doing well. I hope you have set your time to study, maybe early in the morning or late in the night. But I hope you're doing it sincerely, okay? Now, children, as you already know, we're doing Unit 1.2, The Thief Story. We'll continue with this interesting story. This is your third video. And let's not forget, the writer of the story is Ruskin Bond. Just a little flashback of what we've already done. We spoke about the two characters in the story. We know of the narrator, who is a thief, thief meaning a robber, and his name he gives as Hari Singh. That's not his real name, but that is what he lied, okay? And he meets the stranger man, Anil, who is watching a wrestling match, and he tries to get friendly to him. And finally, he even convinces Anil, okay? And he tells Anil that he's going to work for him, and he knows to cook. And Anil tells him that, see, I can't pay you. But Hari Singh says it's okay. Okay, and he thinks that, you know, he can rob him. And he goes to his house and Anil gives him place, you know, to sleep on his balcony. He even gives him the key of the house. He starts trusting him. And as a month has gone by, their relationship has grown. And one day Anil comes home with a lot of money. And Hari Singh sees that. And he even sees that he has tucked it under the mattress. And he decides now it's, you know, time for him to rob. And he decides that he is going to do it. So let's see what happens. I hope you have opened your textbook. We are on page number 10. Anil was asleep. A beam of moonlight stepped over the balcony and fell on the bed. I sat up on the floor, considering the situation. If I took the money, I could catch the 10:30 express to Lucknow. Slipping out of the blanket, I crept out up to the bed. Anil was sleeping peacefully. His face was calm and unlined. Even I had more marks on my face, though mine were mostly scars. Now here we see Hari Singh, or the narrator, as you know, he was waiting for a chance. Now he's going to rob the money. So he's waiting for Anil to sleep. And Anil has gone to sleep there. And you can see the moonlight, a beam of moonlight stepped over the balcony, okay? And it fell on the bed there. And here the narrator sits on the floor and he's thinking, what should we do? What should I do, okay? How should I go about, you know, he's planning. Always remember, a thief always plans how he's going to rob people. So here he has already, you know, planned in his mind. He says, if I took the money, I could catch the 10:30 express to Lucknow. So he has planned to take a train. So slipping out of the blanket, I crept up to the bed. So he moves up to whose bed? Anil's bed. And Anil was sleeping peacefully. You know, Anil, he trusted Hari Singh so much. So he was sleeping peacefully. And his face was clear and unlined. Now, what do you understand by unlined? Showing no sign of worry or anxiety. No worry or anxiety, okay? So anxiety is the same meaning, worry. So Anil was sleeping so peacefully, you know. He did not have any tension, you know. He was sleeping there. And what the narrator is saying, even I had more marks on my face, though mine were mostly scars. Now we know, children, that the narrator, Hari Singh, is much younger than Anil, okay? He's just 15 years old. But he says that on his face, he had more marks. And most of the marks on his face were what? Scars. You know, now, there's a nice question given on your left-hand side. What could have caused the scars on Hari's face? You know, sometimes people have marks on their face. Now, Hari had a lot of marks on his face, scars, that is called scars. Now, why did he have all the scars? What do you think, children? Now, he was a thief by profession. Maybe sometimes he was caught by the police. He was beaten up. You know, sometimes while running with the money, he must have fallen. We don't know what could be the reason, but he had more scars. And that is what the narrator is saying, no? When he compared his face with Anil's face. My hand slid under the mattress, searching for the notes. When I found them, I drew them out without a sound. Anil sighed in his sleep and turned on his side towards me. I was startled and quickly crawled out of the room. Then the narrator says that he slid under the mattress. You can see there in this picture. He puts his hand under the mattress, searching for the notes. He finds it and then he doesn't make any sound, okay? And Anil sighed in his sleep, meaning he made a, you know, took a deep breath and he turned on the side of Hari Singh. So he was startled. What do you mean by startled? He was a little shocked, you know, because that Anil turned. And quickly he crawled out of the room. When I was on the road, I began to run. I had the notes at my waist, held there by the string of my pajamas. I slowed down to a walk and counted the notes. 600 rupees and 50s. I could live like an oil-rich Arab for a week or two. When I reached the station, I did not stop at the ticket office. I had never bought a ticket in my life, but dashed straight to the platform. The Lucknow Express was just moving out. The train had still to pick up speed, and I should have been able to jump into one of the carriages, but I hesitated. For some reason, I can't explain, and I lost the chance to get away. Now here you see, he's on the road, he's out of the house, and he's running. You know, a robber always runs because he's afraid and he wants to escape. And he says that I had the notes at my waist, you know, held there by the strings of the pajamas. Okay? He had hidden his money there and he slowed down to walk and counted the notes. For a while he said, let me at least see how much money I have taken. And there he sees 600 rupees and 50s. It was a big shock for him, you know, so much of money. And he says to himself, now I can live like an oil-rich Arab. You know, Arabs are supposed to be very rich. Because we talk about them where they have, you know, because they export oil, no? So oil-rich Arab. He's saying, I can live for a week or two, you know, spend money. And then when he reaches the station, he does not stop to the ticket office. You know, robbers don't buy ticket, okay? Many of us also may not have, you know, buy the ticket. But here he's saying he has never bought a ticket in his life. So he dashed straight to the platform. Now you can see the Lucknow Express there. It's moving out. The train has still to pick up speed. You know, he was a young boy. He could have jumped into the train. But he did not do so. He hesitated. Hesitated meaning he stopped for a while. He paused. He doesn't know why he did that. He couldn't explain himself. And he lost the chance to get away. Now there's a question here. Why did Hari hesitate to board the train? Why do you think, children, that he hesitated? Probably he must have thought of Anil, you know. Anil has been a person who trusted him. You know, he was a person who gave him shelter in his house. He gave him food. Okay, he even educated him. He was teaching him. So somewhere he felt, you know, something was wrong. When the train had gone, I found myself standing alone on the deserted platform. I had no idea where to spend the night. I had no friends, believing that friends were more trouble than help. And I did not want to make anyone curious by staying at one of the small hotels near the station. The only person I knew really well was the man I had robbed. Leaving the station, I walked slowly towards the bazaar, through the bazaar. Now here, when the train had gone, you know, he found himself standing on the deserted platform. What do you mean by deserted platform? There's no one there. You can see it's all empty. And he had no idea where to spend the night. He had no friends. Okay? And he believed that friends were more trouble than help. You know, many a times your friends can be of more trouble. They may try to help you, but actually their help may land you in trouble. That is what he's trying to say. And he did not want to, you know, go and stay in a hotel, because that would be, you know, people would think, why is this boy come in the middle of the night, you know, to book a hot room in the hotel? So anybody would be curious. So he didn't want that to happen. So the only person he knew really well was what? Who was that? Anil, the person he had robbed. So leaving the station, he walked slowly through the bazaar. In my short career as a thief, I had made a study of men's faces when they had lost their goods. The greedy man showed fear. The rich man showed anger. The poor man showed acceptance. But I knew that Anil's face, when he discovered the theft, would show only a touch of sadness. Not for the loss of money, but for the loss of trust. Now, you know, this narrator, Hari Singh, has been robbing, you know, he's been in this profession probably from a very young age. Okay? So in his short career, he's saying, as a thief, he had studied men's faces. What do you mean by men's faces? Now, you know, if you look on your right hand side, these are all the different kind of reaction people show. Okay? This is the face, you know, in different situations. So he's telling, you know, the narrator is saying, the greedy man showed fear. If he had come to know that his money is robbed, he would be, you know, afraid and frightened. The rich man would get angry. The poor man would show acceptance. Acceptance meaning, he would say, okay, theek hai, abhi kya kar sakte hai na? Acceptance. But I knew that Anil's face, when he discovered the theft, now what would Anil's face show? He would show what? Sadness. You know, Anil would have felt sad, that is what the narrator said, because he trusted the narrator. And when he would come to know that he is robbed, he would feel sad. Not for the loss of money, not that he lost his money, but the loss of trust. And that's very important in life, isn't it? Trust. When you lose people's trust, you have lost everything in life. So we stop here for now. We'll continue with the story. Let's look into the meaning. Now, some that you've already done, children, flattery, modestly, grunting, appealing by fits and starts, queer, we've done that, okay? We've already done that. Now, unlined is showing no sign of worry or anxiety. Scar, now this is not there in the textbook, but I put it there because some of you may not know the meaning, okay? So what is scar? A mark on the skin that is caused by a cut that skin has grown over. You can just say a mark on the skin, okay, that is caused by a cut. Then deserted, empty, because all the people have left. And hesitate to pause before you do something or before you take a decision. And who hesitated here in the story? The narrator. Or you can say Hari Singh. Alright, so I hope you are doing your regular work, children, and you are attempting your assignments. I hope you are even doing loud reading at home. Learn the meanings, okay? Once you learn the meanings, you will get confidence and you will be able to do your assignment also well. I have put in a small assignment for you. I hope you do it and I hope you will enjoy doing it, okay? That's important. And when you see your marks, even if you get less marks, it's okay. Try again. Don't try to copy and look into your book. First study and then attempt the assignment. Thank you, children, for giving me a listening ear, and God bless you. Take care.